All right. So I just want to do a quick video on just an impromptu update on what's been going on, what I've been working on, all that cool stuff. So it's been about 2.5 months since I quit my job in an attempt to be able to sustain myself online. Truth be told, I'm probably not really any closer to that goal than I was about 4 months ago, and that's okay. I'm working on it, and the thing that I'm really happy about is I'm just working on things that I am enjoying, and I'm trying to not place so much emphasis on trying to make money, trying to make money, trying to monetize, because I'm finding that the more that I do that, the less that I enjoy things. So, sure, it may take longer the way that I'm doing it, but I'm also having more enjoyment for what I'm doing. And if that means that I need to get a new job at some point to sustain myself financially, then I'm at peace with that. I know that this is a long journey, and I'm just trying not to rush the universe's timeline. I'm just trying to let it happen and just focus on what I can do and go from there. But I'm working on web design predominantly is like the main thing that I'm working on trying to improve. So right now I'm working on building out a fictitious brewery on Webflow, which has been really fun because I've been able to essentially come up with a brewery idea all on my own. So I'm basically doing all the fun parts of opening a business, but without all the work. So I'm creating the logo, the beer names, obviously the website. But with doing that, I've had to learn a lot of interesting things that I would not expect. And that's what I love about doing these kinds of projects is I learn so much just by doing, as opposed to trying to watch tutorials or take courses or whatever. Like I had to learn how to do an age verification through JavaScript. I had to learn how to use more JavaScript to do a slider. There was something else I had to use. I had to learn a lot of JavaScript. And so anyway, I find it very interesting to learn about. And as a result of doing this project, where I've had to implement a lot of custom code, it's taken me down the rabbit hole of, well, why don't I just learn how to code as well? Or at least get a better understanding of it so that when I do web design, I'll kind of have maybe a better idea on how to implement different functionality and all of that. So I've been doing free code camp and I've been liking it. It's a little hand-holdy in the beginning, more so than I would care for, but that's okay. And the thing that I like about it, though, is that it is very much a, you just sort of get in and start doing. There's not a lot of reading involved, which I really like. It's just a matter of just get in and do the thing. My air conditioner just turned on. I'm going to turn that off because it gets kind of loud. Okay, I'm back. All right, so I've been doing free code camp, and that's been nice. So I haven't really touched JavaScript yet, so I'm going through the HTML and CSS, and I find it to just be really interesting because it just gives me further knowledge on the underpinnings on how the websites that I make in Webflow actually work. And yeah, I just find that to be enjoyable. It can be a little bit of a slog at times, but I think it'll be worthwhile, and especially once I dive into the JavaScript component of Free Code Camp, I think that'll be really neat as well. Because that's something that I'm really interested in is how do I get more, I don't know, how do I like do more advanced things in Webflow? Because I have a decent idea behind how to use Webflow and use all the native features in there. But how do you go beyond that? Because when I do think about the future and how I want to like monetize web design, I know that I just need to be really good at it. And I know that, well, this is sort of my thought process, is that I feel like a lot of people aren't going to pay for just run-of-the-mill web design when they can just use Squarespace or Wix, right? So whatever I bring has to like solve a real problem. It needs to be something that actually takes a high degree of skill to do. And so that's also another reason why I'm going down this rabbit hole of learning how to do front-end development alongside Webflow. Is it just sort of adds to the tools that I have, the arsenal of skills that I possess, and the fact that I also enjoy doing it is a bonus as well. So that's what I've been working on with that. And of course, as you know, if you watch this channel regularly at all, trying to stay consistent with YouTube, I've upped my frequency to 2 times a week. I'm hoping that that's sustainable. I think it should be, as long as I'm not working a traditional job, I should be able to do this. It's really just a matter of, do I have enough interesting content ideas to post at 2 times a week? And if I realize that I don't, then I'll just go back to once a week. But I figured I would try to stretch that creativity muscle and see if I can go about doing that. And aside from that, I've just been working on trying to craft better thumbnails, create better video ideas. It's a really weird balance because I'm trying to not always make videos that cater to an algorithm, or really rather make titles that are clickbaity. And I know like some of my titles sometimes tend to skew that way, but I try not to make it overly abundant. So I'm trying to like strike a balance between, you know, it's nice when my videos get views, but also striking a balance between that and just like kind of like what I'm doing now, just doing more authentic off-the-cuff videos, just talking about what I'm doing. And like, frankly, one of the reasons I haven't done this as much as I used to is I kind of got into the cycle of kind of prioritizing views and whatnot. And I'm trying not to like, kind of like similar to what I talked about before, where I'm trying not to like focus so much on the monetization aspect. I'm trying to just like enjoy what I'm doing and just control the aspect of just me trying to improve. I'm trying to also adopt that mindset with YouTube. I'm not trying to just make videos to try to get that viral video or whatever. So yeah, that's pretty much what I've been working on the past few months. So I'm just going to be doing more of that, some Webflow design, some more of the coding. I think after I'm done with this brewery website, which is taking a lot longer than I originally planned because it does have a lot more advanced functionality than I've ever put in a website, because it is taking longer, I've had to push back some other projects. But one of the other things that I might do is work on creating just Swiper JS sliders. And I feel like that could be useful for people. I've gained, through a fuck ton of trial and error, some proficiency with using Swiper JS. So I don't know, I figured it'd be neat to make like a few sliders to, and maybe I could make that a clonable on Webflow for people to use or whatever. And yeah, I don't really like to try to predict too much of what I'm going to do in the future anymore. I just try to like take it day by day. But that's pretty much where I'm at. Trying to think if there's anything else really going on. Not really. Personal life, I'd like to take another trip, but I also am trying not to blow through my savings money quickly. So I don't know. The trip thing is kind of up in the air at this point, but that could happen. I don't know. I don't really got anything else really, but I hope you're doing well. If you've watched to the end of this video, that's amazing. And I hope you are having a great day, whatever you're working on, or even if you're not working on anything, I just hope you're enjoying life and doing whatever it is you like to do. And as always, thank you for, you know, watching these videos. It means a lot, especially these videos that really don't have much of a structure, really. If you enjoy these kinds of videos, that, I don't know, that always like me almost means the most to me, as opposed to like the videos that I put more effort into, I guess. I don't know. These are the videos I like making, is kind of the heart to heart, just what's on my mind kind of videos. So yeah, I hope you're doing well. And as always, I'll keep you in the loop on other things that are going on. And yeah, we'll see if we can keep these two videos a week, keep that streak up. But if not, hey, I tried. Okay, that's all I got. I hope you have a fantastic rest of your day or night, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care.